geared up for what should be another action-packed edition of WWE Superstars. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Todd Grisham. To my right, WWE Hall of Famer, good old JR Jim Ross. And JR, I think it's safe to say that John Morrison's stock continues to rise. And yet another main event for John Morrison on SmackDown.
Well, certainly John Morrison has got two nights back-to-back with great challenges. John Morrison will face CM Punk. What a main event. Big night here, Todd. How do you feel about broadcasting from Canada tonight?
It's not as cold as I thought it would be.
And from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, weighing in at 260 pounds, from the Hart dynasty, David Hart Smith.
And certainly one of the reasons, the prime reason, obviously, that the Hart Foundation being cheered madly here tonight is that we are in their country. We are on the home turf, so to speak, of David Hart Smith, accompanied by his first cousin, Natalya Neidhart. This should be an outstanding one-on-one contest.
WWE has been in Canada all week long, and the entire Hart dynasty could not wait to show their stuff in front of their home fans.
David Hart Smith, the son of the British Bulldog Davy Boy Smith, and of course, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, the father of Natalya Neidhart.
This has got to be the biggest ovation David Hart Smith has ever received.
Well, it's always good to have the home field advantage. And we'll see how that materializes for David Hart Smith here tonight.
It also doesn't hurt to be 6'5 and 260 pounds, which is what D.H. Smith is.
Smith learned to wrestle before he learned to swim, I would suggest.
David Hart Smith, a third-generation superstar, felt it was his destiny to be one of the great superstars of all time.
You know, I think the young man's got the right attitude, too. These are two of the finest young superstars in all WWE you're seeing right here. There's so many outstanding young superstars in the World Wrestling Entertainment. Hey, we could be looking at a future main event at a WrestleMania-level event someday. You never know how these kids are. What a nice takedown. How these young men are going to continue to evolve. It's exciting to watch them.
But Morrison has beaten David Hart Smith's tag team partner Tyson Kidd back-to-back times. So we'll see how Morrison deals with the strength and power of David Hart Smith.
Well, Tyson Kidd and David Hart Smith are two entirely different animals. And what great matches that John Morrison had with Tyson Kidd. Oh, and look at the double leg takedown.
Morrison willing to go power for power right now with Smith.
I would suggest that David Hart Smith and Tyson Kidd have had some long talks about strategy as it relates to how to beat John Morrison.
Well, David Hart Smith was ringside for both those contests, got a bird's eye view at what John Morrison is all about. Let's not forget, JR, about 2 weeks ago, Morrison was just a hair away from becoming the World Heavyweight Champion.
Without a doubt, and John Morrison continues to build the momentum. And certainly, that's what David Hart Smith is looking to create, momentum, to build his own legacy.
In many ways, JR, John Morrison has gone from the hunter to the hunted. Now other superstars are looking to knock off the Guru of Greatness.
These are two of the toughest young men in WWE, and Morrison's gonna have the advantage on the quickness and the speed, I think. At least that's what we're seeing here. Certainly a partisan crowd here tonight. Hearing John Morrison, as they would like to see their countryman, David Hart Smith.
D.H. Smith certainly has all the intangibles, and one thing that Smith doesn't lack is confidence. The shirt he wore down to the ring said, better than the best on the back. That's pretty good if you're better than the best.
Put your right at the top of the list, and you got a big, strong young man here that knows so much about leverage, so much about submissions. Everything comes so naturally to David Hart Smith, and one has to simply wonder by looking at this young man.
A cover here from Smith.
Just how good David Hart Smith will eventually be.
Well, Smith in many ways is like a Tiger Woods in golf. From day one, Tiger Woods' father bred him to be a golfer. That's what D.H. Smith's family did. They bred D.H. Smith to be as good as he is today.
Standing dropkick quickly done. Morrison is up. As El Shango, it's not quick, he's sudden.
And now Morrison. Natalya getting in between Morrison and Smith. What will the guru of greatness contemplate next?
And over the strength, the hereditary strength of David Hart Smith and the quickness. Oh. What an elbow.
A gargantuan elbow by Smith levels John Morrison.
He just joined us, ladies and gentlemen. Morrison in trouble. Smith going for the cover. We are emanating tonight from Canada, the home turf of David Hart Smith. A very partisan crowd as it relates to the Hart Foundation. David Hart Smith, his dad, the British Bulldog. And look at this. Look at this elbow right here. Boom! Oh. Difference maker. Followed up with another difference maker.
Well, David Hart Smith has done a very good job of grounding John Morrison for the most part. Morrison loves to be dynamic in the air.
Hey, John Morrison's a tough guy. You talk about tougher than a Waffle House steak. John Morrison is just that. He's elusive, but he's tough.
It's got to be a Tim Hortons steak up here in Canada. I don't think they have Waffle House. Morrison trying to get aerial.
And sometimes when you want to take those chances, you pay for them. Look at this. On top of the top turnbuckle. My God.
David Hart Smith with a superplex.
I don't know exactly how David Hart Smith is going to regain the advantage after that amazing superplex that damaged both men.
How many 260 pounders are capable of doing something like this?
Look at the athleticism and the flip over, the instinctual. David Hart Smith, after executing the superplex, bounced from his back to his stomach. That's just instinctive. You're just born with things like that, the little things. It's gonna make this young man a champion. Morrison wants to trade with a 6'5", 260 pounder, but John Morrison's doing pretty good with it. And the Pele kick.
Morrison's never backed down in his career. I don't think he's going to start tonight. Morrison starting to build momentum here, quickening the pace.
You got to believe that CM Punk is watching this one closely. It's Punk and Morrison. Standing moonsault.
And a cover. Two and more. And take a look at this Pele kick from John Morrison. I don't think D.H. Smith ever saw it coming.
About to yell goal.
Not yet. He hit the post.
A little strength here. Look at that power slam.
And a schoolboy roll-up. Morrison using leverage, but not quite enough.
Very quick. Time to cradle. And, look at the strength of Morrison. Good Lord. And what a great matchup. Two amazing young superstars.
Oh, and there's the power. The pure, unadulterated power by D.H. Smith. No.
I took a lot out of John Morrison, obviously, not just the slam, but the pinning combination. I think Morrison is at a distinct disadvantage. David Hart Smith's got to capitalize.
You saw Smith get a little bit frustrated there, wasted a few seconds, and it may have cost Smith.
That's just youth. And look at that.
And now Smith.
He's got it.
I think Smith even had that rhinestone-covered belt of Morrison's, but still, the guru of greatness kicked out and then kicked in to Smith's skull.
Did you see Morrison look over his shoulder and find where David Hart Smith's head was? Morrison was looking for the head. He's looking for more now.
Morrison going for the kill, and oh, Smith able to rise up just in time.
Morrison looking to put it. Suplex, and Morrison landed on his feet.
Morrison able to over-rotate. And now, the flying chop connects. And right now, the Canadian in big trouble. Morrison, will this be the end? Starship Payne connects.
Morrison with the cover. Will it be? Yes. John Morrison in a hard-fought match wins it tonight.
Here is your winner, John Morrison.
I tell you what, we have seen two of the great young stars in many fans' estimation for years to come. The WWE Universe is going to enjoy this ride watching David Hart Smith and that man, John Morrison.
Well, John Morrison just would not give in, adapted his game plan, and it changed right here with that flying chop.
That was a difference maker right there. Turn it around in Morrison, and then had the opportunity for the split-legged corkscrew moonsault by Starship Payne.
Poetry in motion. Look at that.
CM Punk, get ready for John Morrison on SmackDown.
Morrison will be looking for his third consecutive win over CM Punk, and the A-lister certainly looking good tonight. And speaking of looking good, check out WWE.com's Ask the Divas.
I've told a girl that I don't like her, and she still won't go away. How can I make her back off?
If a girl is too accessible, it's kind of a turnoff.
Something disgusting.
Just nicely tell her to settle her tea kettle.
Pick your nose.
Tell her nicely you really don't like her, but you have a friend for her, and introduce her to one of your friends, and maybe magic will happen, and then she'll be off your hands.
If it gets to that point, you have no other choice but to introduce her to your new girlfriend.
I really don't like my friend's new boyfriend. What can I do about it?
Just let it happen, let it take its course.
I would point out all his flaws to her and set her up with a better guy.
Let her be in love. Just let her be happy with the person she's with. You don't have to date him.
Need advice? Ask the Divas at WWEUniverse.com.
Well, speaking of Divas, we're about to see some Divas in action. It's a mixed tag team match. Kofi Kingston and Mickie James, United States Champion and the Divas Champion, team up to face off against Carlito and Rosa Mendes. That's later tonight, but how about this man from ECW? Few hit harder than the Celtic Warrior Sheamus, and he'll go one-on-one with Goldust next.
The following is an important message from World Wrestling Entertainment.
Every day I train.
Thousands of hours of practice.
Injuries can happen at any time.
My kneecap just kind of blew over to the side of my leg.
I've torn the pectoral muscle completely off my shoulder.
I've had surgery 5 times in my left knee.
The tendon was torn off the bone. Couldn't hardly lift my leg anymore.
With every move I make,
my body, my life is on the line.
Don't risk yours. Please, don't try this.
Stryker and Matt, get ready for a match that has been developing as of late on ECW.
We are constantly bringing the action. One of the new superstars making waves is a young man by the name of Sheamus, who is a star without a doubt.
On ECW, Goldust going one-on-one with Sheamus.
Goldust was seemingly in control, but Sheamus took advantage there and was able to get the victory over the veteran Goldust.
I came in search of gold, but all they gave me was dust. I just took one more step towards claiming ECW as me.
Oh! Well, Goldust had heard enough of Sheamus.
Come on, Sheamus! Get out of there, come on!
The road rising to meet Sheamus on the way out. You can believe that Goldust has revenge on his mind.
And from Dublin, Ireland, weighing in at 272 pounds, it's Sheamus!
Sheamus, a part of ECW's new Superstar Initiative, is undefeated since debuting on ECW. Sheamus likes to call himself the Celtic Warrior.
You can see the throngs of the WWE Universe almost enraptured with the angry Irishman. Safe to say, we've never seen anything like Sheamus.
Goldust one-on-one with Sheamus. This is their third encounter. And now here we go. Goldust looking for retribution on Sheamus. Now, what's the strategy now for Sheamus? The third time he's seen Goldust. These two know each other a little bit.
Well, Sheamus needs to continue with what has worked, and that has been his size and his power. Sheamus is very wise beyond his ring years.
Clubbing strike.
Already you can see the wounds of war showing up on the fair skin of the Celtic Warrior.
Corner, Sheamus, come on!
What?
Sheamus has such determination and intent with every single one of his strikes.
Goldust better be careful to keep his aggression in check. Beyond his ring years. That's a veteran maneuver by a fairly young Sheamus.
Wait a minute, what?
I don't know about that.
I'm not sure about this maneuver by Sheamus. Will this match continue? We'll find out after the break.
Their struggle was rooted in championship dreams.
This title right here means the world to me.
Dreams do come true.
But their battles quickly became personal.
The animosity completely running over between these two men.
Now at WWE SummerSlam, World Heavyweight Champion Jeff Hardy and CM Punk go more extreme than ever before. Tables, ladders, and chairs.
Oh my God!
The charismatic daredevil Jeff Hardy defends his championship against the straight-edge superstar CM Punk in a tables, ladders, and chairs match. How far will these men go to stand alone as champion? WWE SummerSlam.
Welcome back to WWE Superstars. ECW Superstars Sheamus and Goldust going one-on-one, and this is what took place during the break.
Very wise by Sheamus, merely cutting the foot out from underneath, and Goldust went crashing down onto those steel steps. And now Sheamus firmly in control.
And Matt, as we get to know Sheamus more and more, the more we see him in action, this is Sheamus's pace right here. Slow his opponent down, grind the match down.
And you'll notice that Sheamus will switch submission holds as opportunities present themselves. Somewhat of an Irish hammer there.
That's the power of the Celtic Warrior. Sheamus into the cover as Goldust leg hook.
Goldust was able to kick out with force and get back to his feet. There's still some fight left in Goldust. like the way that Sheamus is using a path, picking a particular body part, yet not being remiss to focus on other body parts to create openings.
Sheamus once again into the cover, leg is hooked.
Still part of the fight. Perhaps Goldust was playing possum.
Oh, wow!
No question about that. The Irish are infamous for blessings and curses. Not sure which category that falls under.
Come on, Goldust, back in the ring. One. Two.
Superstars have a 10 count to return to the ring. Otherwise, the match is a count out.
Get back in here now.
Sheamus continuing to dish out punishment. Confident or perhaps arrogant smile from Sheamus.
Notice how Sheamus utilizes his time very professionally.
Sheamus rolls Goldust into the cover, tight cover.
This is where Sheamus's mettle will be tested. What is it going to take to defeat Goldust? Will Sheamus become frustrated?
Come on, ref!
Sheamus, another cover.
Two.
Sheamus looks composed right now, Matt.
Again, a testament to the ring savvy of Sheamus.
Come on, Goldust, huh?
Back to that unique vice-like hold, applying pressure onto the head and neck, pounding the larger Goldust as far as height goes.
Matt, not only is Goldust grounded right now, but does this give Sheamus an opportunity to rethink what else can I do right now
Absolutely.
To take out Goldust?
Very, very smart, very astute. Right now, the wheels are spinning inside of Sheamus's head. Well, a submission is not out of the question. See Goldust's face turning colors amidst the yellow.
Wham! Oh, Goldust now! Perhaps turning things around. Oh!
Constantly thinking is Sheamus.
Another cover here by the Celtic Warrior.
Oh, a deep cover too. Again, let's see where Sheamus's head is going to be with frustration or composure.
Been in control throughout this matchup. And Goldust there!
Here comes the Lone Star. Here comes Goldust.
Two.
Those huge right hands staggering the big Irishman. Down goes Sheamus. Josh, I don't know how much was taken out of Goldust.
We're seeing Goldust dig deep here.
Sometimes you dig deep and you realize you don't have a shovel big enough. Let's see what Goldust has. Notice Goldust not using both hands to whip the opponent.
Goldust popped the hips there, power slam, and oh! A second away.
Oh, look at that!
Sheamus went to sweep the leg, crossbody by Goldust. Sheamus rolls through, Goldust is down!
Goldust was very smart to avoid that leg sweep because that's how Sheamus defeated Goldust last week. this match taking all of us on a ride. Perhaps the turning point right now for both Sheamus and Goldust. Superstars have a 10 count to reach their feet. Otherwise, the referee will rule a no contest. Take a look at what put down both of these superstars.
Inside cradle by Goldust. Sheamus is down.
He got him.
Wow.
Goldust took about 2 seconds longer to rise to his feet than Sheamus did. Perhaps Goldust was planning that inside-out small package, Josh.
Goldust kept hanging around and hanging around. And finally, Goldust seized the opportunity.
Sheamus, incredulous and resilient. Take a look here at the ebb and flow. Wham! Both men are down, but notice that Sheamus is up first, so out of nowhere, Goldust with the inside cradle. Shoulders are down.
He got him.
He did get him, yes, barely.
Well, Sheamus is incensed. But still to come tonight here on WWE Superstars, and as our main event, it comes from Raw as the dynamic United States Champion Kofi Kingston teams with the Divas Champion Mickie James to take on the team of Carlito and the fiery Rosa Mendes. Mixed tag team action in our main event.
Kingston.
Hello, I'm WWE Superstar John Cena with a very important message for all of our fans. WWE Superstars are professionally trained performers. The moves that we do in the ring take years of practice to perfect and do safely. I urge all of our fans never try and copy what we do in the ring, at home, or at school. Stay safe. Don't try this.
Monday Night Raw portion of WWE Superstars. Michael Cole, Hall of Famer Jerry the King Lawler. We are 10 days away from SummerSlam, and of course the main event, John Cena versus Randy Orton for the WWE Championship. That rivalry taken up another notch this past week on Monday Night Raw. Let's take a look.
Well, 2 weeks before their clash, Orton and Cena with major tests tonight. John Cena goes one-on-one with Chris Jericho, and Big Show goes one-on-one with the WWE Champion Randy Orton.
The champion cannot be happy with the fact he's got to face the world's largest athlete. Randy Orton could get hurt in this match here tonight.
Not a good time to get injured, but you risk a major injury anytime you face the Big Show. Well, watch out here, Orton.
Big Show, who's knocked out the best WWE has to offer with that right hand.
And Show has that fist cocked and loaded.
And Randy Orton slithering away.
And Big Show will win
this match be a count out?
It may have been the smartest thing for Orton to do. Live to fight another day.
Did you see what happened out there with Randy?
Yeah, I saw it, man.
Okay, he turned tail and ran.
I know, of course he ran. You're a giant. He should have ran. But don't worry, I've got things under control.
One half of the Unified Tag Team Champions, Chris Jericho, versus number one contender for the WWE title, John Cena. And Jericho looking to beat John Cena for the very first time in his career here tonight in our main event.
Oh!
Look at Cena rolls through, and look at the...
Oh, wow!
Attitude adjustment time.
Jericho
Jericho slides down. Falls to Jericho.
This could be it!
Jericho's gonna break his streak.
Oh, look at this!
Reversal by Cena. STF! STF locked in!
Wait a minute, it's Randy Orton! Randy Orton! I heard the bell ring. I think that was an official disqualification.
Oh, and a code breaker! Orton's distraction allowed Jericho to strike.
Uh-oh. Well, wait a minute here. Jericho attacked Orton and he just paid the price.
Hey, Big Show, Jericho's partner. And he comes seeking revenge with a chokeslam.
Ken Hunt as my last official act as special guest host of Raw. I'm going to make a tag team match for next week. Big Show, Chris Jericho, the Unified Tag Team Champions versus John Cena and his partner, Randy Orton.
Can he do that?
He can do whatever he wants. Whoa. As Big Show is taken out of the ring by the soon-to-be teammates.
And now here comes, Jericho!
Jericho, attitude adjustment! Randy Orton with an RKO! Oh, has the dynamic ever changed? Cena and Orton meet at SummerSlam, but they're teammates next week!
My day just got a little brighter.
The following is a mixed tag team match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Richmond, Virginia, she is the Divas Champion, Mickie Chang.
And it's main event time at WWE Superstars. The Divas Champion from Raw, Mickie James.
Wow. Mickie James. She may be my all-time favorite diva.
Her and about 15 others.
Well,
okay. Introducing her tag team partner from Jamaica, weighing in at 221 pounds, he is the United States champion, Kofi Kingston.
And how exciting is this young man, Kofi Kingston?
Well, you can just look at him and tell this guy is filled with energy. He loves being out here in front of the WWE Universe, and they love watching him.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the United States Champion Kofi Kingston teams up with the Divas Champion Mickie James in our main event mixed tag team match next on Superstars.
I will be facing John Cena at SummerSlam.
And I will beat John Cena at SummerSlam.
I am tired of you talking about what you're going to do. So are you going to talk about it? Or are you going to do something about it?
At the biggest event of the summer, the unstoppable John Cena faces the legend killer Randy Orton for the WWE Championship.
You're staring in the face of 250 pounds of problem that is ready to rip your body in half.
WWE SummerSlam.
The Raw portion of WWE Superstars, United States Champion Kofi Kingston, the Divas Champion Mickie James.
I spit in the face of people who don't want to be cool.
And making their way to the ring, the team of Rosa Mendes and Carlito.
Wow. There's Beauty and the Beast.
Carlito has been immersed in quite a spat with his brother Primo over the past few weeks. And
it looks like he hadn't been getting along with his hairdresser either.
there, the lovely Rosa Mendes.
Look at Carlito's hair tonight.
My cat has coughed up better looking hair than that.
People who don't want to be cool.
At one point, Rosa Mendes, a protege of the Glamazon Beth Phoenix, and perhaps down the road could be a contender for Mickie James' Divas Championship. Well, Carlito has gone through some sort of metamorphosis as of late, you think?
Yes, he's in a bad, foul mood about 99% of the time.
Whoa! Now Mickie and Rosa exchanging blows.
These Divas are tying it up early.
I don't believe this matchup's underway yet.
Oh, let him go. Let him fight.
Remember, this is a mixed tag team matchup. The rules are the Divas must face the Divas and the Superstars face the Superstars.
They're trying to get a little control here so he can ring the bell and start the match.
Match underway. United States champion Kofi Kingston squaring off with Carlito to start things off. Hey, Kofi Kingston has been one heck of a United States champion over the past couple of months. He has taken on all comers, all types of challenges.
And he's been in some matches that he would be have to be considered, at least on paper, the distinct underdog. I mean, even against the Big Show, and he's still the US champion. Here we go.
And a kick out by Carlito. Yeah, Big Show has put Kofi to the ringer. And look at this, another kick out by Carlito. Although Kofi, he held his own at points. Kofi, another cover on Carlito and a kick out.
Well, every time. Kofi explaining to Carlito that he was that close to get pinned.
Kofi Kingston has defended his United States Championship in fatal four-way matches, a six-pack challenge.
Well, and with every successful title defense, I mean, his confidence level has to just grow leaps and bounds.
Carlito's confidence level much more vicious and aggressive.
Carlito just snapped out.
Remember this change in Carlito really began to occur when he and his brother Primo lost the unified tag team titles.
This change in this Carlito in this match occurred when Kofi talked a little smack, talking about how close Carlito came to being pinned, and man, that raised the ire of Carlito Colon.
Carlito turning his back on his brother when they lost the tag team titles. He blamed Primo for the loss.
Oh, look at this, look at this.
Oh, backslide by Kofi, great athleticism. Roll out of two by Carlito.
Wow. And you can't hear that.
Gonna cover the United States champion. Hook in the leg and a kick out. Be a big match for Carlito if he could pin the United States champion here tonight. Same for Rosa Mendes if she could pin the Divas champ.
And believe me, that's the foremost thing in both those competitors' eyes. They would love to be right.
Clothesline. Another cover by Carlito. And Kofi rolls the shoulder out.
Anytime you pin the champion in a non-title match, man, that puts you right up there with the top contenders. You deserve a title match.
Mickie James would love to get in this matchup. If Kofi does make the tag, remember, Carlito has to get out of the ring. Rosa will have to come in to face Mickie.
I'll be glad to see that. Mickie James literally hopping up and down. She can't wait to get in that ring.
Carlito controlling this portion of the matchup.
Oh, look at
Kofi. There's the quickness.
Kofi went head first into the top rope. He's still jumping.
And the leaping ability of Kingston. And this is Kofi's game. Get your competitor off balance.
You ready for this, Michael? Kofi, I think, ready for a little boom.
Nope. Carlito.
Oh, Carlito able to spoil the party.
And Mickie realizes she's allowed into the matchup legally and wastes little time going after Rosa.
Mickie wanted to welcome Rosa Mendes into the match.
Well, you know, Mickie, every diva is a potential challenger for her championship and wants to make a statement. Mickie James, only the second diva in WWE history to hold the Women's Championship and the Divas Championship.
Ooh. Oh, wow. That low drop kick right in the face.
And a cover by Mickie, hook of the leg, and Rosa kicks at it too.
Rosa's in trouble from the get-go on this. Uh-oh, that may change the tide. Big elbow right to the side of Mickie's jaw.
Heard about Rosa in recent weeks. She's got a mean streak.
And she'll do a little showing off, as you see right here. Oh. Shot to the gut there from Mickie James.
Now Rosa's dominated the Divas champion.
Rosa's
I don't know about dominating, but definitely holding her own there. She was trading forearms and punches with Mickie James.
Kofi trying to wheel Mickie back into this matchup as members of the WWE Universe.
Here she comes. Our fans on their feet, got this entire arena rocking.
Boom! Divas knocking heads.
I think they did go head to head on that collision.
Tag made.
Yeah, now Kofi gets to come back in.
Look at that! And remember, Mickie does not have to make a tag.
Did you see Kofi Kingston just leap completely across the ring?
Ooh, what a drop kick. Danny drop kick to the jaw.
I don't think I've ever seen that. Here's what he got cut short on earlier. How about a little boom?
The scintillating Kingston.
And maybe it.
Leg on Carlito. Got him, no. Kick out at 2.5. Kofi thought he had him.
Carlito just giving a little bit too long to revive himself. And
what athletic, ability.
Revive himself after that. Wait a minute, what's Rosa doing here? Keep your corner.
Oh, look at this.
Watch it.
Rosa. Allowing Carlito to get back in this matchup.
A distraction by Rosa there. Oh, man. Big rip shot there from Kofi Kingston.
Look at Kingston again.
Look at him.
Wow, what a crossbody.
That's got him.
Lateral press. He got him. What? No, at 2.5. Carlito kicked out again as Mickie and Rosa go at it.
Oh.
Oh, man.
Nobody home.
And a backstabber.
Oh, no.
From the top rope. And Carlito has pinned the United States champion.
Boy, Carlito did pin the United States champion emphatically. What a devastating move.
Big win by Carlito and Rosa here on WWE Superstars.
Well, I thought Kofi Kingston had won it with this move. Huge crossbody block off the top rope. And this was 2 7/8. But it didn't get the job done. And then watch, Carlito able to move out of the way and then the backstabber from the top rope. Wow.
And with that, Carlito pins the United States champion, making a statement here tonight on WWE Superstars.
Great match and a big, big victory for Carlito and Rosa.
Have a great night, everybody. Thanks for joining us on WWE Superstars.